Good morning, students. Today we'll discuss about the schedulability analysis and optimality of rate monotonic algorithm. In the last slide, we have discussed about these temporal parameters, definitions of periodic task model. In brief, we know that the four tuple model is associated with rate monotonic. That what are the parameters associated, phase is associated, the execution time is associated, period is associated, and the deadline is associated. These are the four tuples for periodic tasks. And rate monotonic is also come under the fixed priority scheduling approach. There are two approaches, RMPA and deadline monotonic approaches. Rate monotonic scheduling, we know the smaller the period, the higher the priority, and a kind of fixed priority preemptive approach. As the request rate is reciprocal of the task period, the task with the smallest period will get the highest priority, and the task with the largest period will get the worst priority. Okay, so now we'll discuss about that, what are the problems of scheduling. The problem of scheduling can be divided into two sub-problems. One, deciding whether a feasible schedule exists according to a given scheduling algorithm. And we know that what is a feasible schedule. Feasible schedule means if the given task sets are able to complete before deadline, then we can say this task set is schedulable. Okay, so schedulability is a very big challenge, so also known as feasibility analysis or schedulability analysis. So this is the problem of scheduling. Another is if a feasible schedule exists. Okay, first problem is that feasible schedule exists or not. So for that we'll conduct the schedulability analysis. Second is, if a schedule exists, finding that proper solution or building the schedule is another assignment, another problem. So these two, are you clear? Schedulability analysis is used to predict the temporal behavior of real-time systems. The schedulability analysis uses notions of schedulability test to determine whether the deadline of the given task will be met at runtime or not. The predictability is the primary requirement of real-time systems. As we all know, the all systems, real-time systems, are predictable, giving guaranteed or best effort services. Properties required by schedulability analysis. There are the properties that it must be applied a priori. The analysis must be applied before the system is placed in running state. It is so because at runtime a task can miss its deadline and may result in serious consequences in hard real-time systems. The analysis must be sufficient. The analysis is said to be sufficient if it shows that a given task will always meet its deadline, then it must always do so. The analysis should be as close to necessary as possible. It means if the analysis indicates that a task is not guaranteed to meet its deadline, then there should be circumstances under which it might not. Okay? So, there are three clauses we should apply in the priori. First clause, another one is it should be sufficient. And another one is the analysis should be as close to necessary as possible. Okay? The schedulability analysis is said to be sufficient and not necessary if it shows that a task cannot meet its deadline, but still deadline of task can be satisfied. Okay, then in that case, it will be sufficient and not necessary if it shows that a task cannot meet its deadline, but still deadline of task can be satisfied. If analysis is both sufficient and necessary, then it is said to be exact. If analysis is both sufficient and necessary, then it is said to be exact test. Okay. Comments on schedulability analysis. Although the schedulability analysis can be done online, however, in fixed priority scheduling algorithms, the schedulability analysis is generally performed or computed offline. This we all know about that processor utilization factor. Utilization is divided, execution time is divided by the period. Here, execution time or computation time is represented by CI and the period is represented by the TI. It is that fraction of total processor time which is spent in execution of the task set. The total processor utilization U is given by following equations. So this is the utilization. Now we'll calculate the least upper bound of the processor utilization factor, that is defined as the minimum of the processor utilization factor over all sets of tasks that fully utilize the processor. See, we want the utilization of processor is 100%, and that's why what is the schedulability analysis in general, that utilization, the value of U should be less than equal to 1. But if we'll calculate that at we want to ensure the minimum value, that's why we are calculating the least upper bound that the processor utilization should not be less than this. The processor is said to be fully utilized by a given task set if corresponding priority assignment is feasible for the set, and if an increase in the processing time of any task in the set will make the priority assignment infeasible. The threshold value of U can be derived by scheduling the task set under critical instance, phasing, and identifying a full utilization task set with smallest utilization, which becomes the least upper bound. In next slides, we'll see that what is the least upper bound. The theorem says that for a set of n periodic tasks, n periodic task is represented by tau 1, tau 2, and tau n. Okay. With deadline equal to period, the value of I will be varied from 1 to n. And fixed priority rate monotonic scheduling algorithm, the least upper bound of processor utilization is given by the following equations. It should be n 2 key power n minus 1. N varies from 1 to n. As the number of tasks increases, the scheduling bound converges to log 2 or 0.69. Hence, any periodic task set can be scheduled by the rate monotonic algorithm if total utilization is less than or equal to 69%. Okay. We want processor utilization to be 100%, but the least bound is 69%, and that is given by this n 2 key power 1 by n minus 1. Test based on rate monotonic scheduling. In general, any periodic task set is schedulable by this U should be less than equal to n 2 key power 1 by n minus 1. This is the least upper bound. The coverage of schedulability test is sufficient but not necessary. Time complexity of the order of O n. The exact schedulability test, the test should be both necessary and insufficient. Test based on the exact inexact test will be sufficient but not necessary. But if we are fulfilling both conditions, both necessary and sufficient, then that test is schedulability test, is exact schedulability test to determine if task 2i can meet its deadline under worst phasing. An expression of cumulative demand on the processor made by all the tasks between 0 to t is given by this equation. Okay, this is the theorem, this is the equation formulated or generated by several steps, but you should remember this for that, what is the formula for exact schedulability test. This sufficient and necessary schedulability test states that the entire task set is schedulable if and only if this equation will be satisfied, and where the equation Si equal to k dot Tj, j equal to 1 to I and k equal to 1 to Pi upon Tj. This test is termed as a scheduling point test, since the elements of all these are the scheduling points that need to be considered for checking the schedulability of periodic task. The worst case time complexity of this exact test is exponential and data dependent. Now, what is the optimality of RM? The processor utilization factor achieved by RMPA scheme for a given set of tasks is greater than or equal to the processor utilization factor that can be achieved by any other fixed priority assignment scheme under the above assumptions. Optimal in the sense that no other fixed priority scheduling algorithm can schedule a given task set that cannot be scheduled by a rate monotonic scheduling algorithm, but only if deadline equal to period for all tasks 1 to n. Example, if we can say that two task set of system which have the deadline equal to period equal to 2 in one task and execution time is 1, in another deadline equal to 1, period equal to 3 and computation time or execution time is 1. So we'll check in rate monotonic which job having smaller, which task having smaller period. T1 is having smaller period because it is 2 and 3 is larger. So T1 has higher priority than T2. Schedule produced by RM is invalid. Valid schedule possible with priority of which that pi 2 should be greater than of pi 1 produced by DM. Okay, so this is all about the schedulability analysis and optimality of rate monotonic algorithm. I hope this is clear to you all. If you have any doubt, you can mail me. Thank you. Have a nice day.